in a Maserati, Maserati, maybe the Bugatti, 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 Bugatti. They're telling me I'm too flashy, too flashy. Pull up in the Maserati, Maserati, maybe the Bugatti, 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 Bugatti. They're telling me I'm too flashy, too flashy. In a way, vroom, 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 vroom.
You might see me in a black Mustang, no cap. I leave through the back door in a black van. Or see me in the Maybach, lay back with a tip ting game. Back boom, boom. Or see me as gay in a bouquet. You might see me with Savvy in a Mazzy as you got. Too flashy, too flashy. Backseat than a black cab. You might see me in a black Audi, just lie me. With my gang full rally. Beg you, give me space, please don't crowd me. Turn the fun out, tits up real loudly. This dream break, bust down. I know when the yards get like a touchdown.
Hey man, I'm doing all right. I bought this car yesterday for $1 million, and it's only maxes out at 740 performance points, but I'm able to beat the 800 performance point races with it, so it actually has turned out to be quite a good car. The only disappointment really is that it doesn't have a interior cockpit view, but it's pretty nice. I'm liking it. Definitely making my money back with it. And I'm learning how to drive these races without cutting corners and stuff, so I'm getting better. I'm better and better at this. I'm enjoying the game, even though it's been full of disappointments. It's still a good game. I'm enjoying it, so. But yeah, I think 3.5 million at the moment. I've made, I think, around 20 million in the game. And I'm buying all the concept cars as we and trying them out, just kind of seeing how that goes. I'm buying all the $1 million concept cars and road cars. So yeah, I'm working on my car collection. I tried to play PvP yesterday, but I couldn't get anybody to join any of my races, so whatever. Went in to do the Grand Theft Auto weekly update, and now it doesn't come out until fucking 4 o'clock in the morning, man. Like, Jesus. So that's kind of a brutal thing. I was too tired to make a video last night. I didn't really know what to make, how to make the video, because I didn't know what's going on since the next gen updates come out. So I just looked over the next gen update, and now, you know, part of the update is exclusive for PlayStation 5 and Xbox X, and part of it's for everybody else. So it's kind of a, I don't know.
GTA last night, but I was too tired
to. Yeah, you know, I mean the game is running really nicely in terms of how smooth everything feels, and the graphics and the cars feel great, and you know, the explosions are cool, and now the new tire smokes, and you know, so I mean the game is definitely much better in terms of how it looks and how it feels. It's just, yeah, you know,
I just don't have anybody to play with anymore, you know? And I don't even know what to do in terms of in the game, because, I mean, it's still the same old content that I'm playing that I've already overplayed to death, right? So I'm kind of bored with it, like, to be real. So that's kind of a bummer. I don't know. But it is what it is. I'm sure there'll be some new content that'll come out at some point. Some kind of an update. I just was never really into racing in Gran Turismo, but maybe. Or, I mean, in Grand Theft Auto. But maybe Gran Turismo or Grand Theft Auto is racing might actually be better now with the new vehicle mechanics. But who knows? I put up a weekly update. Of course, nobody's interested because my update came out fucking whatever it was, 9 hours after the update, so. But at least I've got all the detailed information in the description and whatnot. But I am liking this Aston Martin. This is actually a pretty nice little car here. I haven't tried it in the 700. Contact mission playlist. Yeah. They're paying double. Yeah, they are. Okay, checking out old content even if it's not super profit. Yeah, I know. Even the Howe's time trial or whatever is paying triple money. You get 750,000 for that. I've never really been into any of those, though. I am really kind of saddened about The Crew. Like, here's a game that I really enjoy, and I can't play it. I don't know. I've got to go and reset all my driving mechanics, because they changed the driving mechanics in their game, and now everything's just way over-sensitive. So, like, I'm trying to drive, and I'm literally flying all over the place because the steering and everything is too sensitive. But I've got my shit all maxed out because it was all built on the way they used to have their mechanics set up, so.
I'm down next time you get on GTA.
Yeah.
Is there a new Crew game on the way?
There probably is, but I don't expect The Crew new game to come out until at the very earliest November of this year. And you know, if they're smart, they won't issue a release date or pre-sell the game. You know what I mean? If they're smart, they'll just make the fucking game and they won't pre-sell it, and they'll release it when it's ready. They won't give anybody a release date. They can give us an idea of what's to come. But as long as they don't pre-sell the game or give it a release date, it's going to be an awesome game. Hopefully, though, they have some offline play with that game, which would be nice. So if you could play The Crew, The Crews, which is what I'm going to start calling it, instead of The Crew Online, it'll be called The Crews, instead of The Crew 3, just The Crews. So it's kind of a play on words. You got your crew, but then there's multiple crews in the game, and you'll be cruising. So yeah, I like to play on words with that one. So I like The Crews as the name, and hopefully that comes out within a year. But nicely polished with a good offline mode. Should be great. I'm looking forward to it. I'll be buying that game. You know, but I don't think I'm going to be buying much in terms of any more PlayStation games, man. Like, I'm pretty much fed up with the disappointment on release of new games, so. But yeah, you know, Gran Turismo here is a little hard and challenging to get going with, I guess. But once you get an idea for how the tuning mechanics work, And once you've passed through the cafe and you've unlocked everything, you have a whole bunch of cars that you can play with. You know, and it is a bit of a bitch making money. But I pretty much saved most of my money while I was doing the cafe work. And I had, I think, around $500,000 by the time I was done with the cafe stuff. And I had won a couple good cars during the cafe thing. So if I, you know, if anybody uses that $500,000 and tunes the right car, you know, for the tournament races, like I'm doing here, then you're all right. But really, these tournament races are pretty much the only way to make money without wanting to punch yourself in the throat. I mean, there are other races that you can do that pay more money in a shorter period of time, but you're just racing the same fucking race over and over and over again for money. That's gonna drive you insane. Or at least when you're in the tournaments, you've got multiple races to play with. So I can do two or three different tournaments, and at that point I've raced like 10 different maps or different tracks, right? So you're playing the game instead of grinding, really. But you are making money. So I don't even know why I put the term
26. Haven't really played this game much lately.
No?
How many books are there?
39. 39 menus. And once you get to the 39th menu, then it unlocks these tournaments that I'm doing. And this tournament here will pay me $450,000 in an hour and 10 minutes. Right? The other tournament will pay me $250,000 in, I think, 30 minutes or 40 minutes. And there's a... The quickest one is doing time trial, which you have unlocked right now. It's a time trial tournament where you do time trial forward and then in reverse. And if you do it with the clean race bonus, you get $100,000. And it's only 4 laps in total. So it's an easy way for a new player to make some money. So... It's the Trail Mountain Tournament. And there's no performance point limit on it, so you can use any car. I think it has to be an American car, but you can use any American car for it. And you're set. I'm going to check on my dog here. If she wants to come in or what.
Which location for the TT?
I'll show you. I can't show you while I'm doing this. When you go to your list of races, it's at the bottom. There's a list along the bottom that shows you your tournaments. So it'll be in the first couple on the left, the bottom. It'll just say time trial, and it'll say there's 2 races in the time trial tournament. And basically, the first race is you do it forward, and the second race you do it in reverse, and there are only 2 laps per race, and you get 30,000, I think, for the race. But if you get the clean race bonus, you get 45, maybe you only get 25, but anyways, you get 30,000 with the clean race bonus, which gives you 60 for each race, and then you get a $40,000 bonus for winning the tournament, so you get $100,000. So it doesn't pay much. But when you win the tournament, it actually works out okay. And it takes me 8 minutes to do the 4 laps, right? So you make $100,000 every 8 minutes. Which actually pays you... Yeah, it pays you more money than I'm making on this tournament right now.
Thank you for liking the stream and subscribing to the channel.
Like, the tournament I'm doing pays less than that. So, it's actually a good moneymaker if you just wanted to grind that one race out. Or you grind that tournament out over and over again for a while. You do it 10 times, you make $1,000,000. And it'll take you 80 minutes. So 1 hour and 20 minutes to make $1,000,000. Where here, in an hour and 10 minutes, I only make $450,000. So that Trail Mountain time trial or Trail Mountain tournament pays double what I'm doing right now. I just can't race the same race 10 times in a row. But it's okay, I'll pop in there and do it a couple times. Right? And you can race it with the Tomahawk, which I've done. There's no performance point limit on it, right? So you can just go in there with the Tomahawk, totally maxed out and blow everybody away, right? That's the fastest car for it. You want to do it in the absolute shortest period of time. But I've also done it with the Camaro LZ1. And you can max out that Camaro too, like, you know, give it the most downforce and the best tires and everything. And it's still pretty good for that. I'm actually quite impressed on this, Aston Martin here. Because this is only 740 performance points. And it's got no nitrous or anything. And I'm able to beat all these 800 performance point cars with it. So, yeah, I'm actually pretty happy with this purchase for $1 million. It's got really nice brakes. I've also found that turning your traction control down gives you a lot more power in the turns. So traction control at one is actually pretty good. Lets you power out of your turns. I'm actually able to race clean with this car too, which is pretty interesting. I don't get any clean race bonus on this tournament though, strangely. But without cutting corners, I am about to take first place. There we go. I'm in first. So even in that Trail Mountain tournament, if you didn't get the clean race bonus, like if you bump walls or you hit another car, you'll still make 80 grand for winning it, which is still reasonably good money for a 4-lap race on Trail Mountain, right? Trail Mountain's a pretty easy track. It's kind of it's a fun track. Hey, how's it going, Oaks? Good to see you. Welcome to our Gran Turismo grind. I am currently racing the Aston Martin DP100 VGT concept car in the 800 performance point GT tournament. And this car is only rated at 740 performance points. but I'm having no trouble winning. So, for a $1 million car, this is actually pretty nice. I'm playing with my traction control down. It seems to give me a little bit more power coming out of the turns, but it can be a little touchy, so you gotta be a bit careful with it. Yeah, nice little car though. It just doesn't have the cockpit view, unfortunately. Out of all, you know, it's the second $1 million car that I bought that doesn't have a cockpit view, but it's a really good car. I'm impressed with it. It's a, yeah. Tuned up at the max, it's only 740. I'm going to try this in the 700 race. I think I can tune this down into the 700 range. Let's see how it does in that. I think I'll have no trouble winning that. We'll check that out after this. Uh-oh, sit. My bad. A little bit of a late braking there. Oops. This dotted line, man, I need to remove it. I only had it on for night racing when I was on the Nürburgring, because I couldn't see where the damn turns were for some reason. I was having a hard time seeing where I was going. So I put it on, and then I forgot to take it off. But we are having some fun. But the Trail Mountain Tournament is a four-lap tournament around Trail Mountain with the clean race bonus. You get $100,000 for every 8 minutes of gameplay. And there's no performance point limit on it, so you can race it with the Tomahawk if you want to. And it's pretty easy money there, 100 grand every 8 minutes. On a track that isn't a rally car racetrack, right? Sometimes on this particular race, it starts to rain. Any luck? I am not gonna get caught in any rain. So far, we're racing clean, and we're well in the lead. Uh-oh. I see nobody behind me, man. Like, I am just flying on this thing. Now, my Pagani is a faster car, but this has got really good handling and good acceleration. Got a good power to weight ratio. I think it's 800 horsepower, 2,900 pounds, or 3,000 pounds. So, not bad at all. Well, this is the car I did my last sleepy video with. I get people that unsubscribe because of that video, man. They come online, they expect to have the chat with me and stuff, but I'm like asleep, so they get mad. But it's just a way of having something up on my channel, right? I mean, I could have nothing up, right? Or I could have something. But there's a way, you know, for me, that's a way of having content up while I'm sleeping. So it lets me have something going 24 hours a day now. I can showcase a new car each day. I'm not sure what we're going to spend. We're going to buy another $1 million car here today. I'm not sure which one, though. You know, the electric car might actually be okay for this too. I mean, I think it's got that electric Porsche. It's got the same gear ratio and top speed and stuff. I might try the Porsche on this next. See how it does. It's just a lot heavier of a car, so I don't know if it doesn't have the braking I don't think this car has. But this is really nice, man. Like, for a car that's ranked with such low performance points, to be able to beat the 800 championship with it, it's impressive. Now, I beat the championship with the Volkswagen GTI as well, but also had similar performance points in the 740s. But I don't think I won every race with it. I won here by like 9 seconds. And I've only got 739 performance points with this car. So not bad at all, actually. Yeah, 3.5 million. I thought it was just a really weird looking car when I bought it, because I was thinking to have some space age cockpit view interior, but it had no cockpit view at all. So I was like, oh, I was all kind of disappointed there. But, you know, I'm at the end of the day, I'm pretty happy with how good it drives. Yeah, I do. Like, I when I go to sleep, I do escapes video. So it'll be my car of the day for Gran Turismo, and then I'll turn on the escapes for it. And while I'm sleeping, people can pop in and they can listen to music and they can watch the car drive around and stuff. And they can chat with other people that are in the chat. So it's just kind of it's a sleepy stream. Just one of those things I do now, just to keep activity on the channel, so that there's something there. I guess some people don't get it, but some people do. You know, I don't have many people that subscribe to my channel for Gran Turismo content. A lot of them are more the Crew 2 and Grand Theft Auto, really. So, yeah, I don't know. I guess a lot of people probably don't like it, but some people do. For me, I like it, you know. I'm not going to sit there and watch the whole 8-hour video myself, you know, even. But, you know, I like to go in and listen to the music sometimes. I'll have a cup of coffee and I'll check out the car. And, yeah, it looks cool. Give people some ideas about what to buy. Moving up here, I'm in 8th place after the first lap. Coming in hot on this turn. There we go, we're into 6th. Into 4th. Racing clean. Here we go, 1st and 2nd right in front of me. Take these guys out by the end of the 2nd lap. Not bad. First place. I'm 60 performance points below these guys, man. So, yeah. This might be like one of the best cars out there. For 800 performance point races, I don't know. It's impressive, man. Mainly, I think it's because you don't have to tune it down at all, right? It's maxed out at 740 performance points. But, yeah, it's a nice little car. Now that I'm in the lead, I'm not too worried about my speed anymore, so I'll run my traction control high so I don't wipe out, hopefully. Whoa. But yeah, there's actually an interesting difference in top speed there. Usually I would be doing 300 coming into that turn, but I was only doing 250, 260. Well, the traction control does affect your speed quite a bit. As long as you don't turn your traction control off completely, you're okay. So it's good to have it on. Like, if your traction control is at 1, you still have it, and you still have the power coming out of those turns. You know, at 2, you get a little bit more traction. I don't know how much of a difference it makes between 1 and 2, but... You do get better power coming out of the turns, which means you have better speed on your overall race. With it off, though, you're likely to just spin out. But this car I'm driving is 4-wheel drive, so I'm not too worried about that. It's a nice little car, this one. Austin Martin, huh? There's another Austin Martin there, but it was like 3.6 million. So I bought this one for the 1 million. And it's worked out. I don't know which car to get next, though. We'll go shopping before this video is over. And we'll buy another million-dollar car and try it out. I got 2 laps to go still. Final lap. I'm way ahead of these guys, man. I can't believe how easy it is to win with this car. I just didn't see that coming when I bought it. They lose a bit of traction at nighttime, so I don't know if it makes a difference, but I turned the traction control up a little bit. There's nobody behind me, man. I won by over 10 seconds. Crazy. And this is the final race. I'll take a minute here. 2 seconds. Smoke break.
You slept good, good, didn't you?
You had a pretty good sleep. Yeah. Pretty good. I mean, I let the video run after I woke up, had a shower, took the dog for a walk, came back. Excuse me. Made the Grand Theft Auto weekly update video. I think I'm gonna have to change my template for that video though, because now with the new content that they have every week, I don't know if I've got really enough room to put everything in it. I mean, I still can make a Grand Theft Auto weekly sale video, but it doesn't look like there's much on sale this week to make a video about. There's only like 4 cars or something. So, I don't know if I'll do a weekly sale video. It is my birthday next week. Can't believe how fucking old I am. I don't even know how old I am. I'm gonna have to look that up. I'm gonna have to do the math on that. Hopefully I can get through my birthday without having any alcohol. Now whenever I drink, man, I get really sick, dude. Like, I fucking, there's definitely, something's not right. Like, I think I've had my limit for alcohol for my lifetime. Oh, I don't think I'll be drinking much anymore. Which will be good. That means I'll be able to quit smoking as well.
Winking face.
I feel like a dinosaur, bro. I used to be really good at video games, man. Now I'm just barely average. So, well, yeah, I don't know if you bought this car, Bulldog, but it's a good little car, man. I'm only ranked 740 performance points in this 800 tournament, and I've won every race with it. By 10 seconds.
Thank you for liking the stream and subscribing to the channel.
And that's without any nitrous or anything either, so. This is an awesome car. This is the Aston Martin. Yeah.
Everything in the used car lot.
Oh, yeah? This is an Aston Martin DP 100. It's Impressive.
I have never drinked alcohol, so you can drink for my lifetime, huh?
No, I didn't drink either until I got into my 30s, and then fuck, man. You know, it used to really make me sick when I was younger. Like, I'd have one or two beers, and the room would be spinning on me. Like, I'd be just sick as hell, so I didn't like it. But it ended up being part of my work, my job. You know, I was always meeting my customers and shit, taking them out for dinner and parties and looked out to Vegas and shit. So alcohol just ended up kind of being one of those things, and I would drink just to look like I was drinking, and I wouldn't drink because it would make me so sick. But I'd order like a scotch on the rocks, and I would just sip that one fucking 2 ounce drink for like 6 hours or until the ice melted, you know? But yeah, eventually though, I ended up getting a tolerance for it over time, and then was able to drink without getting sick. And then ended up, you know, drinking on Christmas and drinking on New Year's and drinking on birthdays, and next thing you know, I got to a point where I would have a drink and then I couldn't stop drinking because I would just get, you know, I'd get sick. Yeah, man.
I graduated high school in 87.
I skipped from grade 6 to grade 10 in 87. I got my first apartment in 87. Oh, shit, man. I was working full-time in 1988, and I had my own apartment. And granted, I was really young for that, you know. But, yeah. I had a fucked up life, dude. Like, I literally... I did my adult life when I was a teenager, and now I'm doing my teenage life as an adult. So it's all totally like scrambled eggs, man. Makes no sense, but yeah. Right now, I should have a wife and kids and a mortgage, right? Instead, I'm fucking just chilling out playing video games all day. You know. I have a little YouTube channel. I'm not trying to be a YouTube superstar or anything. I have this channel. Originally, I just built the channel to see if I could. You know, and it's been cool. I met some awesome people on this channel.
About 7 years behind me then.
I'm pretty close. I'm not 50 yet. Still got a little ways to go for that. I still look really young for my age, though, so that's good.
Niche coming for me this summer.
Wow. Yeah. I'm still going to be in this crappy motel for my birthday, though. Oh well. I finally managed to go out and buy some clothes yesterday. Oh. I didn't buy much, but I got some shit that I really needed.
Mike, I thought you were in your 30s right now.
No. I'm in my 40s, dude. I am old. Once I turned 40, it all went downhill after that. My eyesight went, my reaction time went, my cognitive skills went, my memory went. I was like, what the fuck is going on? You know? I was a good gamer until I hit my 40s, man. And then boom, it just all fucked like overnight, man. It's like, wow. And then, you know, I just try to chase shit now. I went to play Grand Theft Auto. I can't remember how to fuck to play. I don't remember what buttons do what and shit now, you know? for a game that I've got 10,000 hours in. I can't even remember the fucking buttons, so... Yeah, I got the early signs of dementia coming in. It's kind of a shame, but... Let's see if we can get into first place here. I don't know. This car is going to be able to do it by the end of this lap. But we still got a whole lap to go, so we got lots of time to catch up. What's our speed at? 300. Looks like our top speed is 300. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. There we go. Good recovery. Well, these guys aren't too far ahead of me. I think I do need that traction control. But yeah, this is really good for being 60 performance points below the required limit for this race. And I've already won all the previous races with it, so I think it's the brakes that are really the winner here. It might be the acceleration. Brakes and acceleration. It doesn't have the top speed, but it's got everything else. Pretty good handling. Good power to weight ratio on the car. But this little dotted line is hypnotic. It puts me to sleep when I start watching it. Nice little exchange back and forth with the Supra. We should just leave that thing in the dust here pretty quick. I bought a lasagna yesterday. It's frozen. I don't know why I bought it, because I am so sick of eating pasta. That Supra is still behind me. I haven't totally lost it. I guess I'm 6 seconds ahead, so I'm going in for another win here. I think I've got my fastest lap time with this car as well on this track, which is pretty crazy. I don't know how to check that. I see your like stats for your tracks, like what car you got the fastest lap times with and stuff. I don't know if those settings are easy to find.
Easy to find.
Yeah. Well, I really hope that they bring out some new races and new content and new tracks and cars here in the next few weeks. I think they really need to do that to bring this game back up to its former glory here. Because I'm at a point now where I'll race a couple tournaments and then, you know, I don't know, there's just not enough content to keep me engaged like previous Gran Turismos did. But I really wish the crew would add the whole haptic feedback to their racing. Now, because I didn't realize how, you know, important it was until I went back to that game and all of a sudden I couldn't, it just felt so hollow without it. Because now with Gran Turismo, Cyberpunk, and Grand Theft Auto, they've all got the haptic feedback when you're driving. And I'm pretty used to it now. Like, I don't know. Games that don't have it now are like, I don't know. We're kind of getting put on the back burner. But I really do like playing the crew. I mean, it's a pretty awesome game. I like the graphics, and I love the video editor and all that stuff, man. So.
Is the vibration important to you or the triggers?
I think it's the triggers. Mostly the triggers. Yeah. You know, because you don't, when I'm racing with haptic feedback, I'm not pulling the gas pedal and the brake pedal. I'm not slamming them, right? With haptic feedback, you're able to be easy on your brakes and easy on the gas, right? So yeah, it's a big difference there in how the car performs and takes the corners.
Subscribing to the channel.
But before, without the haptic feedback, like I was always just, you know, full gas, full brakes, right? Oh, of course. I just, you know, because I'm moving all the time, I just can't carry a bunch of stuff with me all the time. I can only buy what I can fit in my car and drive down the road with. Unfortunately, I have not been able to get a stable place to live now for a year and a half. Or it's been a year. It's been a year I've been destabilized with my rental situation. So I am on my I'm moving into my third place in 1 year, right? So I'm literally, and I'm driving 800 kilometers from place to place just to find something that I can afford. And yeah, the rent has gone up, is more than doubled across this province that I live in. So my standards of living have gone down, like a lot, a lot. This place I've been living in for the last 5 months doesn't even have a kitchen or laundry. Like, fuck me, right? Like, yeah. I'm literally in a hotel room with nothing but a microwave and a little mini bar fridge, right? So this here is the race where you get $100,000 every 8 minutes if you get the clean race bonus. Yeah, seriously, it's been brutal. Why the hell do you think, like, in December, I just fucking lost it, man. I almost had a nervous breakdown when I moved into this place. Literally. I just couldn't take it. I had gone from a two-bedroom Mountain View fucking townhouse that had a hot tub and Bluetooth Wi-Fi fucking washer and dryer and heated floors and 15-foot ceilings and a huge gas fireplace and beautifully furnished with 200 up and down internet and everything into a fucking tiny little fucking, 350 square foot hotel room with nothing but a bar fridge and a microwave. You know? With internet that's only running at fucking 60 megabit download and 16 upload. So, yeah. Yeah, I wasn't too happy. Of course I did. Property values have gone up. Price of all foods have gone up. Groceries gone up 40%. Rent has doubled. And everybody's fucking pissed off with a chip on their shoulder, ready to punch you in the face the second you say something they don't like. And these people that are renting places are fucking, like, really weirdos, you know? They're fucking weirdos, man. You do not want to end up in a shared rental situation, because then you don't have any rights. They can steal your shit, they can threaten you with violence, they can ask you to perform sexual acts for them, or they'll kick you out. You don't want to be in that situation. Even when you're renting a basement suite, like, say, where the owner lives upstairs, they're still going to try and control your life and tell you what you can and can't do and stuff. You know, they'll tell you you can't have people over, you can't have your girlfriend over. They'll tell you all sorts of fucked up shit, man. They'll tell you, you know, I don't know, man. Yeah, I tried that. A small piece of land is $100,000, and a tiny house is about $80,000. So, yeah. And a tiny house at $80,000, that is for about a 450 square foot little cabin with a septic system and electricity hooked up to it. And then the land is about $100,000. So, yeah, not happening. Not in my budget. But yeah, for the race here, Moneymaker, this Trail Mountain, you can race with any car that you want. And you get $100,000 every 8 minutes. And it's only 4 laps, 2 laps in each direction. So I got my Tomahawk at 980 performance points against these little cars, and I'm just gonna smoke them. Whoa. Two laps around Trail Mountain for $100,000. As long as I don't hit anybody, I'll get $100,000. If I hit somebody, then I only get fucking 80. Or $60,000. Or 40, I don't even know. If I don't get the clean race bonus, I'll get $80,000.
there's a guy who built a 370 square feet house for under 12,000 Canadian.
Oh yeah, hey, my uncle back in the day, he built a 4,000 square foot house for under 80 grand. You know. This is Canada in 2022, man. You know, it's after the pandemic with inflation on everything from lumber to fucking housing, building materials are through the roof. Nobody wants to fucking go to work. So chances are, if you try to get somebody to build something, it's never going to get built. You know, they're going to take your money and run away with it. Like, everybody's just fucking turned into thieves, man. You can't even trust anybody, dude. I'm serious. I contacted a guy. He's a home builder. I gave him a customer that built a fucking $2 million house for with him. That had him build him a $2 million house, right? And they didn't skimp on anything. It was a really fucking high-end property. And, you know, so I called the same home builder back, and I'm like, listen, yeah, you know, I mean, I gave you that $2 million deal, which would have normally net me a commission of at least $100,000 for that deal if I was a salesman working for him. And I asked him, you know, I want to build a little cabin. I know I don't want to go over $50,000 on the build budget. Can you help me? And he's like, no fucking way. And I'm like, Jesus, man, you know, I just gave you a $2 million deal and you won't even help me build a fucking $50,000 cabin. Yeah, I know. But yeah. Oh well. I don't really know what to do right now. I put in an application, or actually I didn't. Somebody else found me and they put me in a waiting list for low income housing. But I did look at that property before and there's no dogs allowed. So I don't know. I'm not going to give up my dog for a place. This is Trail. Yeah, it's the Trail Mountain Tournament. There's no point. There's no performance point restriction on it. You just have to have an American car.
Only if you had like a friend in this industry.
Yeah. Right. Clean race bonus. It's only $20,000 per race, but with the bonus, you get $30,000, right? And then you get a $40,000 payout for winning it, and it's only two laps. So it's two laps in each direction. You get $60,000 for the four laps, plus a $40,000 bonus. Trail Mountain Cup Race 2. So it's $100,000 every 8 minutes, which works out to $1 million in 1 hour and 20 minutes. Which is more money, that's double the money that I'm making doing the GT tournament on those five races. If I did this over and over again for an hour and 20 minutes, I'd make $1 million. Oh shit, don't lose your clean race bonus, man.
Damn, you're smoking these cars.
I'm in a Tomahawk. The thing's almost 1,000 performance points. And these cars are like 600 at best. And I'm not even using the nitro. Oh, crap. Here, I'll use the nitro. Hey, what's going on, Devoni? Welcome back. Thanks for everybody that did like the video. I know, like, YouTube has really been hard on me.
The Daytona Tree Oval is 52K in under 3.5 minutes, but gets old.
Yep. Yeah, it does. I bought the game to play it. I don't want to ride the same track over and over again. That would just ruin the game for me if that's what I had to do for money. So, like, I'm actually not grinding because I'm enjoying my gameplay. So, this isn't a grind. This is just racing, just playing, winning, making money. Well, my final lap for $100,000. I did hit the wall though, so I might have lost a clean race bonus on this lap, but that'll only cost me 10 grand. But you know, there's a whole pile of different cars that you can do this with too, right? You don't have to use the Tomahawk. But I was like, wow, there's a race I can use the Tomahawk in. Yeah. Right? I can use this. Go. Easy as pie. Oh, I didn't get the clean race bonus because it smashed into the wall. So I made 90 grand. Oh well, still good enough. I'll take it. You do got to be careful too, though, now. I mean, I'm still getting the odd copyright strike during my live streams while using their streamer mode or whatever, broadcast mode. So, yeah, just a heads up there. I don't know what the fuck, if I should bother contesting the copyright strikes. You know? Or whether there's more to come in the future and I just, you know, they're waiting for me to have, 30 videos out, then they'll copyright them all. I don't know. But that was 979 performance points in a race that was designated for 600. So yeah, it didn't take long to do that. All right, give me something good to eat, motherfucker. Come on. A 2-star ticket. I'll take a big stack of gold bars. No, I'll take that little BMW. It'll be all right. I don't know what that is, but I'll take it. Oh! Oh! Man.
Thank you for liking the stream and subscribing to the channel.
Crown Athlete G Safety Gear. Tuning part. For compatible vehicle, Toyota Crown Athlete G Safety Car. Like, okay, I'm gonna end up with that. Fuck. Jesus, man, you know, I just feel so burned every time I get the fucking roulette ticket. Just like, no. So how much money have we got? 3,972,000. Anything interesting in the used car collection? Nothing has changed since the last time I looked. Brand Central. We're going to find ourselves another $1 million car here. And we bought this Austin Martin already. This is pretty nuts. This other one, that green one there, that's 3.6 million. A little out of my league. 3.3 million. That 820 horse, 2,900 pounds. It's probably a good car. Rear wheel drive, though. And I bought this guy. This is what I've been racing. And it's 800 horsepower, 3,000 pounds. So I figured that looked like it was going to race pretty good. And it just didn't have a cool interior. It has no interior at all. Kind of a bummer. McLaren-wise, I'm looking for road cars. I don't want to buy race cars. So I think these are the only two road cars they have. Everything else is racing. Right? It's just kind of a bummer that way. I already own this thing. I bought this. This was a cheap car. 240,000. But by the time I tuned it, it ended up costing me fucking 700 grand. And it's not really that good of a car. The X-Bow might be the better choice there. I don't know about buying this thing. It just looks ugly to me. It doesn't look very interesting. Performance-wise, only 239 horsepower. Oh, it's only $126,000. 1,700 pounds. I already have this one, which has been a really good car. It was 551 horsepower, 2,600 pounds, four-wheel drive. I don't have it.
Coming to every stream, where's my cookie?
Yeah, right? This is a race car. That's a race car. That's a GR3. That's a GR3. That's a GR4. Oh. Alright. Did we only get one car for these guys? No, he's got a whole bunch of cars. There's a road car. The safety car. 500 horse, 3,500 pounds, 3,400 pounds with the big lights on the roof. No. 419, 31, no. 570, 35, no. That's a road car. 719, 33. Racing, racing, road and road. Oh, racing and road. Oh, there it is. This one's a little bit, this one's the better car. Slightly more performance, but it's a race car. But this one's the road car.
I like the chocolate chip cookies.
Yeah? I like peanut butter chocolate chip cookies. Does this have an interior? Because the windows are fucking blacked out. It may not have an interior. Be another one of those cars that has no interior. Yeah, I saw that. See, somebody said that if the windows are blacked out, there's no interior on the car. So this might be another car with no fucking interior, man. 576 horsepower. 3,000 pounds. I don't know if it'll even be fast enough. But it's got no... The windows are blacked out, right? You can't see inside, so that probably means... Probably means it's no good.
Is 5,461 horsepower good?
Should be. You found a car that has that kind of horsepower? I don't know if that's good or not. That might be just too much power. It might just be spinning out and crashing into everything. Well, this looks like an interesting car to buy. And no, it probably doesn't have an interior. And that's what I keep running across with these cars, is I buy these million-dollar cars. No, I think it would be ridiculous, man. You'd end up killing yourself with a car like that. This might not have an interior either. It's a racing car. Racing, 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 road. For 300 grand. Aww. It's such a cute little car. 400 horsepower, 3,500 pounds, though. But it looks so cute. I might have fun with that. What's its performance points? 535? I don't know. I think by the time I fucking tuned it, it would be, it would be fucking over 600 performance points. But it might be a cool car for your 600 point races.
395 max power watts, that.
It's a little BMW, two-seater coupe. Z8, an 01 Z8. I didn't know they had a Z8. I mean, I remember they had a Z3 and a Z4. Call to see in a Z8, though. But it's like, there's a car that I wouldn't mind having in real life. You know, that would be a fun little car to rip around in. I can certainly find myself enjoying that. I'm half tempted to buy it, though. But I know that by the time I buy the car and tune it, I'm going to be into it for $800,000-$900,000. So do I buy this? Oh, shit. I don't know what you're referring to. Talks about your maximum horsepower at a certain RPM. I dropped my controller. I got fucking spiders in my bathroom. Well, I lit that one on fire.
It says max power 395 HP.
Yeah, that's your horsepower. So you want to compare your horsepower and your weight. You want the highest horsepower with the lowest amount of weight. We'll give you the best acceleration and cornering. And maybe even top speed. But your horsepower versus weight ratio is where you're going to be able to identify a good car. So high horsepower, low weight is good. Yeah, but if I put a stage 4 weight reduction on this, right, it'll bring the weight down quite a bit. And when I tune the engine, the horsepower will go back up. So it could very well end up being 2,500 pounds at 600 horsepower. By the time I'm done tuning it. I'm sure it'll get over 500 horsepower. I say, what do you guys think? Should we buy this? I don't have a BMW. I do, actually, but not a cool one like this. In first person, this actually might be fun to drive. See what our color options are. I think we'll have to paint it. Doesn't have much for color options. $300,000.
Is 2008 with 500 HP crew?
Yep. That should be okay. That would be like an expo. So now we can tune the fuck out of this thing, right? Like, because it has nothing. This is where it costs you the money, with all these tuning parts.
Fuck.
What at 1,500 weight witty 7 HP?
Look at my money, man. I'm just fucking burning through it. Wow, now its performance points are over 600 already.
600 HP with 1,500 weight.
Well, my performance points are a little high now. I can put dirt tires? No, I can't. Fuck, man. I've just spent like a small fortune here.
Just spent over 400k on a 300k car.
I know. That's what I'm saying. There you go. And now it's 675 performance points. And that's without the premium tires on it, I'm sure.
SMH bro is pimp chimping.
I don't know what color to paint it.
Than Bill Gates on GT7 face with tears of joy.
Getting there.
Thank you for liking the stream and subscribing to the channel.
I don't have the paint color I want. Uh-oh, did I save the wing? Yeah, okay, we got that. We need some paint. Choo-choo. What do we have here? Dark candy, metallic, carbons. I know. I'm looking for a chocolate. I want a chocolate color. I have matte. Liquid metallic, aluminum metallic, flakes, real paint car, real car paint. What is in real car paint? Oh, that shows you the brands. I'm looking for kind of a goldy chocolate. A milk chocolate. Gold. No. Okay. Flakes. That's too light. Maybe a coppery color. What else have we got in here? Basically, I think I'm looking for a brown. Nope. Dark flakes. There we go. It's hard to tell without looking at your actual car, you know? I just don't like this. These options. And by the time I'm done, I have to buy all these fucking paints just to look at it, what it looks like. Why won't they just show me my fucking car? I have to do it like this. Lazy ass bastards. You can see the flakes in the paint on this color. You know, this just to fucking, you have to buy it just to look at it. Yeah, that looks nice. I like it. Classy. I don't know if I should paint the wing to match the carbon trim at the bottom, or if I should leave it colored. A black wing, or leave it colored. I think I'll leave it colored.
One tape paint looks good on the preview car, but another's face with tears of joy.
Starting to look fairly nice, except for the mirrors. I didn't realize the mirrors are in chrome here. Hold on. No, that's the hood. You can't adjust the color of the mirrors. Thank you. How do I rotate the fucking thing? This is not flipped. The fucking thing's massive. Fuck. Rotate. There we go. Oh, for fuck's sakes. Try to get it at fucking 90, man. I know, right? Trying to get 90. Come on, this is like fucking running the roulette. There we go, 90. Okay. Decal color, black. Okay.
Triangle for direct input.
Oh, all right. Triangle, huh? Rotate.
HHH Bulldog met him suffer.
Magnification ratio 50. Magnification ratio vertical 50. Interesting. Well, what if I go like what? 10? No. Not 510. 10. by 10. I want to place it. Oh.
The hard way.
Oh, God. Why? So 7 and 7. Okay. But is it 7 and 7? Seven. See, that's bigger. So I can go like 7.5 or whatever, right? So let's go with 6. And we'll go 6. Okay. Okay. Now we can get this all the right fucking size. Can't believe nobody told me about this earlier. 6. You guys are mean, man, by letting me go through this without knowing that shit. All right. Now I want to move my decal. Oh, come on. What?
He didn't tell you earlier, bro.
Fuck, man. All this again. Why did it spin it upside down? Back to 6.
At God or Devoni hyphen justice delivered. Stop
6.
Caps. Warning. He
okay.
Told you the first time you did this.
Well, maybe I was too tired to listen. Camera, I do not want to modify, I just want to move it. Oh, for fuck's sake. Edit decal. 6. Okay, now how do I move the fucking decal? low speed, modify, rotate, scale, move. Okay. All right. Okay. I think that's right. This fucking hell.
Would love to help but don't know what the hell is decal is lol.
I may not have them spaced right until I get all the letters in there. Yeah, they're not going to be spaced apart properly. I need to space them further apart. No.
For liking the stream and subscribing to the channel.
Yeah, fuck. So I need this B to be like over here. Too bad they don't have a center option. Fuck. They already look fucking gibbled, eh? Trying to get this fucking shit to be centered.
What's under options when viewing the layer stack?
What? What layer stack? Modify, rotate, scale, move. Check editing area. Camera position, menu controls, decal color, layer controls. Projection range. duplicate symmetrically, duplicate, flip horizontally. I don't know what any of that means. Projection range, limit angle, limit depth, align with surface. Hold on. What is that? I don't know. It'd be nice, though, if I could get these all to fucking line up together. And space out evenly. You know. Ah, fuck. No. Now it's crooked. Ah, for fuck's sakes. Is that straight up and down now? Oh, shit. I need that at zero. Okay. See, now my S is too far out. Fuck. I just want to move that S in a little bit. With the U's not, like, they're just not, it's just not all fucking level, right? It's not, you know, I'm trying to eyeball this, but the U is too high, or the S is too low, I'm not sure which one it is.
That looks good, kinda. Zoom in. You can place a line to align things.
How? Well, it looks pretty aligned anyways. Eyeballed, I guess.
Align with surface.
Where? I don't know. I don't want to... Like, I finally got it, so I don't want to fuck with it now. Decal texture? Interesting. Glossy decals? Whatever, man. This is about as far as I've been able to get so far. Quit without saving? No. We want to save. Overwrite. Alright. I think we're looking good, man. Let's take this thing for a spin. ...669 performance points. Somehow it went down. Maybe by adding the downforce, it decreased my performance points? I don't know, maybe. Let's take this thing out. See how bad it is, man. Okay. Let's go to a race. 669, we'll do a 700 race with this. Sports soft, racing details. Top speed 310, maxed out. I can add downforce, but I don't know if I want to yet. That's all we got, is 669, huh? Well, I might be able to go with the 650 race with this. You know, the 650 might be okay. Nice. My first convertible. It feels like you can't tell if you're accelerating or not. You can't feel if you're braking or accelerating. It feels lifeless. How's it going, toys? Oh, shit. That's what I get for looking up at the menu. Drop that traction control down to 1. The steering feels really non-existent. Feels actually like a terrible car. A bad investment. Bad investment. Feels like a bad investment. Pretty and all, but doesn't feel that great. I'm in 16th place here. I've got to get into first within 5 laps. Suppose wiping out. Like the nitro doesn't even feel like it helps, and the brakes don't seem to work at all. Like the car just feels like a tank. It's got no brakes. Okay, all right, we're exiting for a second. We're gonna adjust some settings here. We definitely need some downforce. I'm just gonna max out the fucking downforce. Let's see what difference it makes. And we're gonna drop the ride height a little. All right, and we've gone up in performance points by 14 points. Let's try that again. Traction control to 1. And we'll bring down our brake balance controller to -1 in the front. Feels better already. Quite a bit better, actually. Well, we might need a little bit more traction control. Shit. Okay. Apparently, yeah, you want more traction control than that, so we'll leave the traction control at 5. Brake balance is still at -1. I think the Miata would kick the crap out of this car. Yeah, we're not getting very good turning ratio with this. So I probably need to raise the rear a little bit in regards to its downforce. I probably would have been better off buying $1 million car. I could have bought that Mercedes, that $1 million Mercedes, for the same price as this. Oh, how disappointing. This just feels like a brick. It doesn't go very fast. Maybe I need to reduce my gear ratio. Because it just doesn't feel like it has any acceleration. But it looks nice, you know, being a convertible. Fourteenth place. Yeah, the braking's not very good. Doesn't brake and turn very well. So, probably should maybe lower the front a little and raise the back. Do the same with the downforce. Maybe. Well, we moved up to 12th place. This guy behind me is just running me off the road. Cute car and all, certainly like to own one, but not impressed with the overall performance. I'm underrated for the race. This is 700 race and I'm only 770 or 670, so maybe this will do better in a 650 race. Just by switching out the tires. When you buy the used cars, do they occasionally come with extra parts on them? I don't think I've got the nitro for this. It just doesn't turn either, so that's weird.
But it comes with miles and engine wear.
Right. Somehow we're in fourth place with this car, so. Second place. Or third. Well, me and this Honda are battling it out for second. Coming up on the final lap. Somehow, I managed to get into first place. Yeah, I did. I dropped it and fucking the car spun out on me. Like, I put it on one. It's just, I don't know, the sound of the engine, I can't, it just feels like a really low revving engine. Well, I am in first though. But I can adjust the transmission, I think. I brought the transmission ratio, gear ratio down a little bit. It might give me a little bit better acceleration. Its top speed is at 310, which means it'll probably do like 340 or 330. But if I bring it down to say 290, I might get that little extra acceleration and still have a top speed of 310 or 320. I am out of nitro. Uh-oh. They're gaining on me. No, I'm pulling away. Huh. I managed to win that. It sure didn't feel like I was going to win that. Like, it really did not feel like I was going to win that. Didn't win by much. Well, there's $50,000 back of the money I just spent on this car. So let's bring the gear ratio down and see if it'll handle better in the next lap. Oh, fuck me. Yeah. I'm definitely going to need something for this track. Okay, so we already brought down that. We want to bring that up a little bit. And I'm going to bring this down a little bit. We went up a performance point. All right. We're definitely the underdog here. I don't think I'm really going to use that 290 in here. I'm going to bring that transmission down even more. That should do her. She seems to be a little faster. How many laps? We got 5. Oh, fuck, no. Fuck it. Cut that corner. Yeah, so my top speed is 285. I could have brought the transmission down even more. Could have brought it down to like 260. I don't know how this will do on the Nuremberg rig now. We're in 11th place. Uh-oh. Damn it. Ah. There's no way I'm going to recover from that. Too underrated for this race. But it might be good for the 650 race. Except it's a European car. I don't know what there is for European cars in 650 range. This feels too heavy of a car. Come on, fuck. Well, we're in fourth place. Maybe. We might actually be able to pull this off. I doubt it, though. Those other guys are way ahead of me. No! Fuck, man! Oh well, that's it.
Isn't it boring to grind the same championship all the time?
I'm not doing the same championship all the time. Nope. It's better than grinding the same race over and over again.
Oh, my bad.
When I'm doing different championships. I'm basically on four different championships that I'm doing for money. Which means that I'm racing around a dozen races. Maybe 15 different tracks, which is a third of what's available in the game, or half in some respect. Those guys are way too far ahead of me for me to catch them. I'm doing all right, man. You know? I'm enjoying this game. I, you know, wish it had more content. You know, I thought that this was going to be, like, being the 25th anniversary. I thought it would be Gran Turismo's biggest release yet, right? With the most tracks and most cars. But I guess I should have looked at the stats or what they were saying was in the game before I bought it. But I'm still enjoying it, you know, all that, you know, all things considered, I'm still enjoying it. And it looks like, you know, they've acknowledged that there is content that they're coming, right? I mean, there's going to have to be some 900 performance point and 1,000 performance point races coming, right? With the Group 1 cars that we can buy but don't have any races for, so I would imagine that there's something there.
only thing I hate is the car prices.
Yeah, the car prices are high, the payouts are low. I remember on Gran Turismo 6, we had races that paid $250,000. There were $250,000 races in Gran Turismo 6. It was also released, it had over 600 cars on release, right? And it had 280 tracks, 650 cars, the release of Gran Turismo 6. And the game was $60. This game is $100, come out with 45 tracks, and 400 cars. So, not the greatest. But hopefully, you know, within a year, that the game will actually have some content. But I'm already at a point where I don't think I've got much more than a week or two left in the game before I'm going to be bored of it. You know what I mean? 2 weeks from now, I'm just going to be like, yeah, whatever. Not going to be that big of a deal in a couple weeks. But at the end of the day, I've got my 200 hours of entertainment out of it, so... I guess at 50 cents an hour, it reminds me of putting quarters in an arcade machine when I was a kid. And then they'll come out with an update down the road, but it'll be too small to keep you playing. Nothing at this point. I'm just buying stuff. I'm buying all the concept cars, really. I got distracted and bought this one. So, you know. Mainly because I like this car, and I thought that, you know, it would be fun to drive it, but it didn't perform very well. So I'm going to drop my transmission even more for this final race. And hopefully, it'll be okay. But I'm not going to be able to pass anybody in that straightaway on Laguna Seca, right? Or I mean on Nürburgring. I'm not going to have the top speed for that straightaway. But with any luck, I'll be able to catch everybody before then. I'm gonna bring my transmission down even more. But I'm
to Platinum GT7. I have 5 trophies left, but they are very time consuming.
Yeah, no shit. 260, huh?
Some of the 3 legendary cars and licenses.
I haven't finished my super license. I'm stuck on the Formula One race. I keep coming up like 2-3 seconds short on the Laguna Seca race with that F1 car. Just to get bronze. So I'm not really that good at the game, you know, overall. But...
same, same.
I still am enjoying it. I'm a little disappointed with the graphics too, though. I mean, like, shit, man. These graphics are exactly the same as what we had on PlayStation 3. You know? This is all 1080p while you're racing.
How are you able to gold it if you can't do bronze?
I'm not. I basically have bronze on everything.
Yeah, I noticed the same thing.
This is a lot better with the transmission tuned down, though, to a lower top speed. Like, I'm noticing that I'm getting a little bit more pickup out of the turns. I'm gonna bring my traction control down.
It's different. I see it more different.
A little, but I mean, I look at games like Grand Theft Auto and Cyberpunk are able to run in 4K with ray tracing. Why this game isn't on PS5 is beyond me. To me, that just tells me that these guys were lazy. The game, they didn't even give us a complete game compared to Gran Turismo 3, 4, 5, or 6, right? Like, I just didn't see this coming from this company. I thought this company was going to give us a complete game, so. But, you know, the red flag was up when they said it was online only, so. I should have known better. But this car's actually doing okay in the turns now with a lower transmission top gear. So, you know, everything's all in the tune at the end of the day. Oh, the support is brutal. Are you kidding? I called up support because my game crashed on me and I lost my tournament money. And they're like, oh, just delete the game. They're like, delete the game and then reinstall it. And no, you're not getting any reimbursement for your credits. We will not be reimbursing your credits. No. It's too funny, right? The PlayStation support is bad. The PlayStation doesn't give a flying shit. They got more customers than they've ever had. They don't mind losing 100,000 customers. You know what I mean? They don't give a shit. You know, about their customers. And then there's support. When you have a problem, all they do is read to you the shit that's already on the website. And I'm like, well, I already read that, sir. You know, I was looking for, you know, some additional help with this problem than what's already on the website. And then they hang up on you, right? And then you call them back and they leave you on permanent hold for 2 hours until they're closed. And then you call them back on a different day and you go through the same process. Or you're actually being really nice to them, talking to them, and they're like, are you antagonizing me? Are you looking to start trouble? I'm sorry, but there won't be any swearing, and you're not even swearing at them, but they're accusing you of it. They're trying to antagonize you into telling them to fuck off or something just so they can get off the phone, man. This is the worst customer experience I've ever had with a gaming company, man. You know, I look at Grand Theft Auto, and I was expecting a bad customer experience, but those guys are like fucking golden compared to Gran Turismo or PlayStation. You know, Grand Theft Auto really surprised me with their customer service. It's actually really good. But Gran Turismo is brutal, man. And PlayStation is brutal. There is no Gran Turismo customer service. You actually have to deal with PlayStation. So, yeah. That sucks. Uh-oh. Let's see if we can recover from that. That knocked us a little back, but not much.
Rockstar support has definitely treated me well over the years.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
In having problems with my net type for a couple of months, it's unknown now, and I can't play some online PS4 games, and I called and they told me.
Oh, yeah. I had a problem with my microphone not working in my live streams. And at the end of the day, the problem was that in the PlayStation setup, the icon shows that your mic is off when it's on, and it shows that it's on when it's off. So even though it was set to be on, it looked like it was off. And it took me 2 weeks to get them to help me with that problem. And they hung up on me. They blacklisted me on the fucking, on the customer service thing, so no matter who I talked to, they wouldn't help me, you know. So, I at that point, I almost fucking packed up my PlayStation and bought an Xbox, you know. But, I'm not sure, you know. I mean, I do like this game, but I mean, this is a Sony exclusive, right? Like, this is... It's just supposed to be the what's better than Forza, right? This is the direct competitor for Forza by Sony, and yeah, I don't know, man. Forza's better than this. Forza graphics are better. Forza car selection is better. Forza tracks, I don't know, are better. Forza has open world driving. This doesn't. You know, I don't know, man. Like, I really think that they dropped the ball when it came to coming out with a PlayStation exclusive racing game that was supposed to be competitive with what Microsoft has. And then the fact that they're just all money grabbing. Like, I pay $100 for a game, I don't expect there to be any microtransactions in it at all. I expect to have access to the whole fucking game, right? Not being told that I have to pay $40 a car, right? I've never gone through this. All right, dude, man. You have a good time, man. And have some vodka for me. Yep. Yeah, I'm usually on every day. It's just every now and then I burn out and I take a little bit of time to myself. But I'm usually on every day. I really have nothing to do, man. I can't afford to do anything else in Canada. Everything's so expensive nowadays. All right, man. Well, thanks for visiting us. And thanks for subscribing if you did. Oh, shit. We're in third place. How far are the first place guys from me? I don't see them.
See you, man.
All right, dude. I don't even see these other two cars ahead of me. I don't know if I'll be able to catch them. I don't think I'm gonna have the top speed. Oh shit. Not gonna have the top speed to catch him in the straightaway. But if I can get first on this, then we'll win the tournament. Otherwise, this is it. What's our top speed at? 295, 300, 301, 302 is our top speed, 303, and we're burning the nitro. We're coming in hot. I'm coming. Come on, where are you? Oh, they're too far ahead. Oh, I couldn't even cut that last corner for the win if I wanted to. Third it is. Well. Not a race winner. He is not a race winner. 20,000 credits and nothing for the tournament. Oh, I got 60,000 for the tournament. I got second place for the tournament. All right, I still made some money, but overall, that's going in the garage, and I'll probably never drive it. But it might make a nice Sleepy Escapes video, right? Oh man, how much money have we got? 3.3 million. Well, the other thing I wanted to try was to the 700 race. This is actually what we just did, was the 700 race. I think that BMW is ranked too high at 685 to compete in the 600 race. But this other car that I bought yesterday, in the 700 race, uh, Look at that. Just by changing the tires, I'm at 691. It's the exact same tournament that I just did, but I wanted to try it with this car. I'm using racing intermediate tires. Well, what a difference this is compared to that BMW I was just driving, man. That Austin Martin. All we did was switch the tires out, and it dropped us into the below 700 range for this tournament. When it punches up into fifth gear, though, the thing just starts hauling ass. This car is fucking awesome, dude. Like, I can't, you know? It's great. I won the 800 race with it, and I don't think I'm going to have any trouble winning this 700 race with it. So, punch her into fifth, and then boom, look at the gear. Look at the speed. Just go. Brakes are still good, even with the racing intermediate tires. And having those intermediate tires on are pretty good too, in case it rains. third lap. Guy's history.
Let's go.
Yeah, it almost feels effortless to drive this. After driving the BMW, this thing feels like a dream.
Hungry, man.
I'm gonna have a quick smoke break here. You want to come up and sit with me, Sasha? Come on up. Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. Where's my dog? She's a good girl. Fuck. Oops. That hurt. Damn. Uh-oh, not again. I need to turn that traction control up a little. I'm losing it in my corners. Oh, come on. Ninth place. Why are you looking at me like that? What? Stop looking at me. Stop staring at me. You're making it hard for me to concentrate when you're staring at me like that. Oh, shit. My dog. Okay, third lap. Oh no. Well, we're not too far out. But having this guy stuck to my side is not helping. There we go. I'm gonna draft this guy. That's the first place guy right in front of me. We got this. I had to scratch my forehead. Final lap. Well, that took a longer. It took a while. Whatever. Next, final race. Alright, let's get this last one done. Yeah, this car's good for the 7 and the 8, so that's awesome. Oh, shit. since we got back most of our money from that BMW. I guess. We got back the money we paid for tuning it anyways. There we go. Fifth gear, and it just goes, man. We're at its top speed here. 300. That is that race. Finished way ahead of these guys. About the same as we did in the 800 race. 10 seconds ahead. $3.6 million. Not bad at all. That is all right. Is there another update? Did I just see something that said update? To all users, information. Update details. Wow, what's that again? Well, I think I'm gonna make myself something to eat. Thank you. These pictures don't look any different, Matt. I can't tell the difference between 80 and 200 kilometers per hour. It looks like the same photo. Oops. It looks like the same thing. I can't tell any difference. Whatever.